Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship here at Cumberland Homesteads Baptist Church. We're excited to have you with us this morning. And before we jump into our announcements, a quick welcome to any visitors that we might have with us. And if you are a visitor, we'd ask you to take this extra portion of your bulletin, fill that out, tear that off, place an offer plate when it's passed by in a few minutes, so we can find out some ways that we can minister to you and your family. There are just a real quick few announcements. Pay attention to your inserts about the poinsettias. And then we have our Christmas card list. If you have any questions about any of that, you can talk to any of our staff. We can help you out with that. Also, yesterday was our mother's ministry, True Hope Helping Hands. Yesterday, we got to minister to 48 families, correct? Over 70 children and over 94 adults represented there. So thank y'all for those of y'all that were able to come and help, and those of you that have helped in that ministry in the past and given financially to that as well. Thank you so much for that. I guarantee you, if you ever get the opportunity to come out and be a part of that ministry on Saturday, you'll enjoy it. You'll enjoy it. It's a great time of ministry. Me and Brother Jared get to have the fun where we get to pray with people just as they come in. It is a great time ministry. I do encourage you to take part in that if you can, if you're able, ever available on that first Saturday of the month. We thank you always.
Second Saturday.
Also, this evening, for our children's program, if you have a child that's involved in our children's program for tonight, please try to have them here at 3:15. And the children's program will be at 4 o'clock. Today is our adult cantata, and there will be no children's church. During that, we're going to let them stay out here so they can enjoy this time of worship and music. Are there any other announcements? Anything else I'm forgetting? There's going to be a bunch of posts.
Well, there's Young at Heart over in the Fellowship Hall on Thursday. And the white elephant, in case you don't know, it's just something you got in your house that it's just taking up the space, and you want to come exchange it with somebody for something else.
Yay! that's this Thursday. That's this Thursday at noon. So if you want to be a part of that, you can talk to Miss Gary. She can give you more information about that. Any other announcements? Anything else I'm forgetting? I do have one prayer request. If you don't mind, I want to mention to you. My in-laws came in Friday to come be a part of our cantata and watch our cantata as well as the children's program. And Friday night, my father-in-law had a heart attack in my living room. He's at UT. They were able to put in two stents. He had a 99% blockage on one side and an 88 on the other. So if you please remember him in prayers, he's still in UT. They're talking about hope, maybe sending him home today. But Rogersville, where he's from, they've already got quite a bit of snow. So we're trying to work out getting him home. If you please remember him and that family in your prayers over the next few days. Any other announcements? We'll go to the Lord in prayer, and I'm going to turn it over to Brother Jerry. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you this day, Father. We thank you for bringing us together this morning. Father, we thank you for the one thing that ties us all together, your Son. Father, we pray for the many things that draw our attention away from you this morning. Family issues, financial issues, things going on at work. Father, we pray that we can put those aside so that we can focus on worshiping our risen Savior this morning. And Father, we thank you for this young man who comes to publicly identify with your Son and follow through in believer's baptism. Father, we pray that you'll move in this hour. We love you. Your Son's name we pray. Amen. Amen.
This is Aiden Benson, and he comes to follow the Lord in believer's baptism this morning. He's written out a brief testimony. It's what he says. He said, a Christian needs to believe that Jesus died on the cross to save our sins, have eternal life in heaven. I pray that the Holy Spirit to come into my life. I confess that I'm a sinner and I can't get into heaven alone, so I have to get Jesus. Dickinson. Upon your profession of faith and obedience to our Lord's command, I baptize you, my brother, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We're going to pray together. Let's pray for him and his family, okay? Father, I thank you so much for Aiden. I thank you for his family, their willingness to teach him the word and to bring him to church, Lord. I thank you that you still save sinners. Lord, I pray for Aiden as he seeks to live for your glory, that you bless him and bless his family. Thank you so much for Jesus and all that you give us in him. In Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Our church, let's stand and encourage one another in the name of Christ.
small portion of the many blessings that you pour out on us on a daily basis, Father. That you'll multiply and use it to further your kingdom in the ways that you see fit. Father, I pray that you'll continue to be with us in the worship service, that you'll speak through our choir. You know, we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
between joy and happiness?
Joy goes all the way to the soul.
Okay. I always tell my kids and happiness is based on happenings, what happens to you. Like, for example, how many of y'all like pizza? Yeah. So, find out for supper and whatnot, you're having pizza. You're happy. Pizza gets there, it's cold. You're not. Things that happen to you can change your happiness very quick. But joy is a happiness that nothing can touch. It doesn't matter what happens to you. Joy is, like what Ms. Garnett said, a happiness that goes all the way down to the soul. You want to help me like this one?
Christmas is a time for family and friends, time for recalling cherished memories and making a new, a time for singing carols, for gifts and celebrations. But more than anything else, this is a time of great rejoicing because Christ is coming. As we gather to remember and celebrate his birth, we recall that which was declared long ago by the prophet Isaiah. To those living in darkness, a bright light now shines. A brilliant light shining over those who live and stand overshadowed by death. Upon them, a great light is shining. Ordinary baby.
He was the prophecy fulfilled. God incarnate, light shattering the darkness, love on display. Yet in the hustle and bustle of busy Bethlehem, few would notice.
Joy, Lord.
was sad to come to the church. There were no streets lined with banners, no road up the way, no crowd to applaud his entrance. What a mystery that Jesus, the Son of God, would come the way he did. Lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." When the angels left them, the shepherds ran to Bethlehem to find Mary, Joseph, and the infant Messiah. God and telling everyone what they had seen and heard. If you've been a witness of the goodness and love of God expressed in Jesus, how can you keep talking about it? Just as the shepherds did, we tell the miracle of God incarnate in a manger. But now, 2,000 years later, we know that the baby of Bethlehem is the Christ of the cross. May we, like those who first heard the angel's announcement, come and behold our King, and then in amazement go tell the good news of the Savior.
Thank you.
glorious good news it is. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. And of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end.
God, we just know and tell.
Concerning Christ or true concerning us, because he has freely done these things on our behalf. Jesus is not only God, he is God with us. And I just want to read one verse here. This is actually a memory verse for my kids' age group in the children's program right now. 1 Timothy 1:15. The saying is trustworthy, deserving of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the foremost. It's the Apostle Paul talking. So friends, I want to encourage you to think about that reality, to remember and to proclaim to one another, to proclaim to a watching world, that if they're sinners, we've got good news for them. If you're a sinner, and as you realize a sinner is someone who's rebelled against God, through Christ you can be brought back into right relationship with God. And God has shown his love for us in that while we were sinners, Christ died for us. And so I want to invite you, if you've never put your trust in Jesus Christ, if you've never repented of sin and trusted in Christ alone to save you, I want to invite you to come. I want to invite you to celebrate the meaning of Christmas. And perhaps you're a believer here today and you're walking at a guilty distance from the Lord. Perhaps you have unrepentant sin in your life. Perhaps you have issues, things that you have allowed to go on for too long. I want to invite you to repent today. I want to invite you to enjoy God's grace afresh and anew. Because this time is ultimately about Christ. And let us enjoy Christ. Let us enjoy salvation. And you cannot enjoy God and his provision through rebellion against him. You cannot enjoy what Christ has done by living an unrepentant lifestyle, especially as a Christian. So friends, let us this morning, a celebrated freshman who all that God has given us in Christ. His brother Kenny comes and leads us in a hymn of invitation. I want to invite you to come. I want to invite you to come be saved. And I want to invite Christians to come and pray. And I want to invite you, if you have any unconfessed sin, to confess it and to enjoy God's grace this morning. Let's all stand and sing.
Thank you.
Any other announcements?
Shall we pray? Lord, 2,000 years ago, you asked a young lady to go inside her to create a child, and the child go out with her to help her. This season, we celebrate what you did to that girl who graciously said yes. Now, Lord, 2,000 years later, you ask every person on this planet the same question. The difference is, if we say yes, we become the child. Thank you for the picture of salvation through your name we pray. Amen.